4. I'm your host, Chris Hurst. I'm going to try not to pace as much this time. Alright, Justin says I can pace. Promotes thought. This week's focus, music for focus, concentration, the science of sounds that help us focus, concentrate, and lock in to a good deep work sesh. Something that I find difficult to lock into sometimes. Focuses on the exploration of the utility of sound. And we are the third Tuesday of every month from 6 to 7 p.m. We're listening to some passive beta wave right now. We'll learn more about what that is. So focus. What are important criteria for sounds that can help you focus? When we're focused, we're tuning out of our distractions. And something called executive attention is at play in the brain. It determines what will have your attention and what will fade into the background. And when we encounter stimuli in our world, in our environment, it leads to a part of our brain called the locus coeruleus to send noradrenaline to different parts of the brain, determining which stimuli grab your attention. Researchers think that ADHD and stress disorders may be part of a result, maybe a result of malfunctioning in the locus coeruleus. Executive attention in the mind allows you to focus. So you're recognizing what is important to you, what is important to your mind, and almost selecting it subconsciously. Focus music blocks out distracting stimuli with one relatively simple stimuli. Characteristics of this kind of music, a general kind of parameters for when you're looking for it, are little to no lyrics. Lyrics are the most distracting part of music they find. That when you got lyrics going on, you cannot focus on what you're doing outside of the music. So it's good for stimulating music, though. Not super bassy. Below 45 hertz, you probably want to cut that out. and less high frequencies, anything above 5 kilohertz. And this is for what they consider, scientists consider to be the most ideal forms of focus music. I personally believe that these parameters are loose and that we can apply them to our reality how we see fit, and they aren't so strict. It's important to listen to music you like when you are looking to focus. Also, for the melodic structure to be exempt from ruptures like pauses, breaks, or major volume deviations. Constant complexity level, which is the type and number of instruments that's going to help focus. Maintaining focus involves not letting your brain get bored. You occupy your brain just enough to let you work, but feeding it novel stimuli periodically so that you don't try to seek novelty by distracting yourself. That's why I like drum and bass for focus sessions. What else we got here? Another point. Brainwave entertainment. It's believed that brainwaves can be synced to external sound waves. I'll say it again. It's believed that brainwaves can be synced to external sound waves. Brainwave synchronization refers to the observation that brainwaves will naturally synchronize to the rhythm of periodic external stimuli. If brainwaves and sound waves can be synchronized, it makes sense that listening to certain types of music can lead to certain brain states. Sleep, focus, relaxation, etc. Services like Brain FM, which is a streaming service that produces a continuous loop of computer-generated music for various desired mental states, utilize a combination of frequencies to help us focus and stay focused. Importantly, beta frequencies in the low range between 12 and 18 hertz. What we're listening to right now is an active beta wave from Matches off of their project Huizcol. The science of these ideas is in its early stages. So I feel like we have a lot of ability as listeners and people that want to focus to pioneer the field, to figure things out for ourselves, what works, what doesn't. Today, we're not going to be sticking to one type of music. We're not going to stick to what might be considered the best music for focus. It happens to be some of my favorite music to use to focus. And we're going to go on a little bit of a journey through what would be some of my favorite examples of music to focus. It could be true that it's better to listen to one kind of continuous sound, and that it might help to focus, but I really like when I'm working and it's like a 2-hour mix and it's a whole thing that turns into me getting really pumped up over the journey and like, whoa, I'm getting more, getting deeper into my work and feeling possibilities to be endless and without a ceiling. So that's personally what I like. And sometimes this kind of droning music without drums or changes isn't necessarily always like that, even though it can be. Like this specific song has more movement to it than what you would normally hear in beta wave music. And I believe the artist's intention was to create pieces that utilize the beta wave technology while having them be more melodic and pleasurable, maybe? But that's about it on my notes. And I think that when you're focused and you have a general feeling that anything is possible, that it's really positive for deep work. And deep work is very helpful for getting deep stuff done. And that's about it. Let's get into the mix. Thank you. Music 4, Episode 3. Live on Miami Community Radio.
Thank you.
Episode 3. Focus. You can do it. And we got Sheila's Alp from Spyro 3, Year of the Dragon. How does video game music help us focus? Are the inner workings of video games meant to keep you locked inside?
JK.
Thank you so much for listening. I'll see you soon. Every third Tuesday of the month, 6 to 7 p.m., Music 4. You can follow us on Instagram at Music 4. 4 underscores after.